13, Revelation chapter 13, verse 13, and he did great wonders, so that he maketh fire to come down from heaven on the earth and the sight of men, and he deceiveth them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles which he had power to do in the sight of the beast, saying to them that dwell on earth that they should make an image to the beast which had the war by a sword and did live, and he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. That's the power of the false beast. And that's the reason you have real authority to be able to deceive them. These entire false prophets with a composite picture of a lamb and dragon combined together, having the appearance of a lamb and the nature and the power of the dragon. We're told, number one, he exercises all the power of the Antichrist, all the power of the false beast. Number two, he had power to give life to the image of the beast. When people see that, they're going to be saying, if you say that this is not of God, see the power of this prophet, of this great man. This is the great power of God. See, he's even able to give life unto image, the image of the beast. And then number three, he'll have power to do miracles and wonders in the sight of the beast. Number four, he will also do great wonders so that he will make fire to come out from heaven on the earth in the sight of the people. But the purpose of the miracles will be not to deliver people from the judgment of God, not to lead people to repentance, and it is not to lead people to experience of salvation or the experience of vindication. The purpose of the miracle is not to make us be like Christ. The purpose of the miracle is not to exalt the Lord Almighty. The purpose of the miracle will not be to worship the Lord in truth and in spirit. The purpose of the miracle will be to deceive people and lead them to eternal suffering. He will deceive them that dwell on the face of there, and it will cause the earth and them that dwell therein to worship the false beast. The source of the power of the false prophet is the dragon, because that's what we're told in that passage we have read already, that is, it is the devil supplying the power to this false prophet to work the miracles. And many times you will not know, even the false prophets of today, the ones that you hear are not just using verbal things or just the word to deceive people, not just that they are clever in speaking as orators, but they really have some kind of power. And then the people that go there, you know, they're putting pressure upon you all the time. It's maybe your husband has gone there, and your husband is putting pressure on you. If you don't follow me to this place, I'm telling you, this man is the great power of God. I've never seen such miracle in my life before. I watched them. I was there. I got near. I went near their platform, near their altar, and I saw the miracles like this with my naked eyes. And you know, the way they catch the witches and the wizards, and the way they point them out, and those men roll on the ground, and then they urinate on themselves right there in the public, and they tear their close right there in the public. When the power of God begins to work, my wife, let us go. And then you say, no, I will not go. And eventually your husband may turn from gentleness to violence. And he says, if you don't follow me to this place, there will be no peace in this house. If you don't follow me to this place, it is because you are afraid, you are a witch, and you are the one disturbing the family, and you are disturbing our business. That's the reason you are afraid, you want to get there, because you know that if you go there, they're going to spot you out. You say, I'm sorry, I don't want to go there. This is false. It is not based on the Holy Spirit, on the power of the Lord Jesus Christ. How do you know? How do you know? You must follow me there. And eventually, if you are not careful, if you go there and then they catch you, and then you are not able to come back again, and then you are hooked there, and you are held down there, and then you begin to drink their water, and you begin to rub with their oil, and you begin to repeat their things, and you begin to carry their pictures about, and you begin to read their materials, and you begin to pray with their prayer book. Already you are gone, and for you to come back, it might be another miracle to be able to bring you back. The purpose of the false prophet of that day, that is of the time of the great tribulation, is not different from the purpose of the false prophets of today. It is to make people slaves of Satan. It is to make people servants of the devil. It is to make people the worshippers of the Antichrist. And then they will take the mark of the beast, and they become irredeemable. It will be impossible to redeem them, thereby making them to suffer eternal punishment with Satan in hell fire forever and ever. And as you look at this, you understand, we've read it already, but let's read it again in Revelation chapter 16, verse 13. It says, "And I saw three unclean spirits like frogs come out of the mouth of the dragon, and of the mouth of the beast, and of the mouth of the false prophet." Now, if you are not a person like John the Beloved, if you are not a person that God will open your eyes to see, when you go to those places, you will not see the evil spirits coming out of their mouth when they give the command. You will not see the evil spirits walking along with them. But John, because the Lord opened his eyes, he saw the evil spirits by frogs coming out of their mouth. And then it says in verse 14, "For they are the spirits of devils, working miracles, which go forth unto the kings of the earth." It will capture the kings. And sometimes today you'll find that a king or a chief or a political leader might go to some of these meetings, and then they will go there, and then the newspaper will broadcast everything, publish everything, and say, you know, great man in society, he was there, and the director of this particular company is gone there too, and the chief and the obas and the obis and the kings and the rulers, they've gone there too, and those people too, they'll be giving testimonies, and they'll allow their testimonies to be in the papers. And then in your mind you are saying, well, these are kings, these are professors, and these are great men in society, and they've gone there already. And so if they have gone there and they have seen miracle and they are testifying about it, why shouldn't I go? They will deceive kings of the earth, because it says, "Which go forth to deceive unto the kings of the earth and of the whole world." Of the whole world. You hear that some people are coming, white people. They are coming from America. They are coming from Britain. They are coming from all over Europe. And they are coming from all the different parts of the world, and they're going to this place, and then they're taking cassettes and videos away to their countries, and they're saying, we have seen power, that man, he has real power. And then you begin to say, since all the whole world, they are going there and they're seeing something, why don't I go there also and at least see? At least I know the Bible and I've learned some things. They cannot deceive me. Let me go and see what they are seeing. And then when you get there, the devil is not a dummy, and the devil is not a foolish, a dumb fellow. He knows how to catch people. Once you are taking that step, and the first step, and you are there, then you are lost forever. Because it says, it is to gather them to battle, the battle of that great day of God Almighty. And that's why you want to be very careful. You don't want to just follow people doing things or going places you do not understand. Because the final scene or the final end of the people, here is what it will be, chapter 19, verse 20. Revelation chapter 19, verse 20. "And the beast was taken, and with them the false prophet that wrought miracles before him, which deceived them that at the back of the beast, and them that worshipped the his image. These both were cast alive into a lake fire, burning with brimstone." That's the end of the false prophet. That's the end of the people that do not follow after righteousness. That's the end of the people that do not follow after the sound doctrine, the transforming doctrine of the word of God. And they prefer to follow the things that will deceive. In chapter 20, verse 10, "And the devil that deceived them was cast into the lake of fire and brimstone, which where the beast and the false prophet are, that and shall be tormented day and night forever and ever." Again, let me remind you, as you hear about miracles, you ought to ask yourself, what's the purpose of the miracles? What is the purpose of the miracles? Because it is the purpose that actually determines, the origin. In the case of God, his purpose is to lead us to repentance. His goodness is to lead us to repentance, that to submit to him so that he can save us, and so that eventually he can take us to heaven. His purpose is to make us know that he is God, and Christ is Savior, and the Holy Spirit is the Comforter, and that the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, they are interested in changing our life, transforming us, and taking us to heaven. The manifestation of the power of God, a miraculous manifestation, is to make us turn away from evil and turn to the the Lord. But in the case of this Antichrist, in the case of the devil, the dragon, in the case of the beast, the false prophet, what is the purpose? Let's look at them one by one. Number one, the purpose of the miracles of the false prophet is to harden the heart. It is to harden the heart. You check up on the people that have gone to these false places, and they have seen, they have said that we're seeing miracles, we're seeing miracles. Their hearts are hardened, and they will not listen to the truth anymore. The miracle alone so hardens them that they will not want to see the truth. They will not want to know the truth, and they don't want to listen to you if you are bringing the truth unto them. In Exodus chapter 7, Exodus chapter 7, I'm reading from verse 10. And Moses and Aaron went in unto Pharaoh, and did so as the Lord had commanded. And Aaron cast down his rod before Pharaoh, and before his servant, and he became a serpent. And Pharaoh also called the wise men and the sorcerers. Now the magicians of Egypt, they also did in like manner with the enchantments, for they cast down every man his rod, and they became serpents, but Aaron's rod swallowed up their rods, and he hardened Pharaoh's heart, and he hearkened not unto them, as the Lord has said. Hardened Pharaoh's heart. If those magicians and sorcerers and the wise men of Egypt, if they were not able to do to duplicate what Moses and Aaron had done, maybe his men would have been softened. But when he called the sorcerers, he said, see what Aaron and Moses, see what they have done. They cast the rod down and it became serpent. This is a great miracle, a great wonder. The Egyptians said, hold on. And then they threw their own down. It became serpents as well. Even though the serpent of the rod of Aaron swallowed up their rods, all the same, it hardened his heart. The purpose of the miracles that these four prophets perform is to harden hearts. And if you have got friends or relatives or backsliders who have been in this church before, and now they have gone astray to some of these false places where they say they are seeing miracles, when you talk to them, they are hardened. As you talk about repentance, you're talking about restitution, you're talking about righteousness, you're talking about holiness, you're talking about the miracles they see over there. They say, well, don't commit sin. Don't sin against God with your mouth. You have not been there. I have been there. I see what is happening there. And don't tell me that it's only in deeper life you are hearing the word of God. You have Bible, you have doctrine, you have everything. But look at the miracles that are taking place. They are hardened because of the evil sin that is upon them already. Number two, hatred for the truth. Hatred for the truth. All those miracles, the purpose of the devil is to make the people hate the truth of the word of God. And that's why you need to be very careful. You need to watch your own heart. As you are hearing the word of God, if you are no more eager like you were reading the Bible, reading the tracts, reading the Sunday scripture booklet, and reading the books that have been published, and hearing the cases, and you just put them aside. Put them aside. I need other things. I want other things. If you are having hatred for the truth, it is the impact and the effect of the deception of the miracles of the false prophets. In 2 Thessalonians again, I'm reading from chapter 2 verse 9. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 9. Even him whose coming is after the working of Satan, with all power and signs and lying wonders, and with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish, because they receive not the love for the truth, the love of the truth, that they might be saved. The love of the truth will no more be in their heart. It will be hatred for the truth. And for this cause God shall send them strong delusion, that they should believe a lie, that they all might be damned who believe not the truth, but have pleasure in unrighteousness. Number three, it is to hinder repentance and redemption. It is to hinder repentance and redemption. And we're told in Revelation chapter 9, reading from verse 20. Revelation chapter 9, verses 20 and 21. And the rest of the men which were not killed by these plagues, yet repented not of the works of their hands, that they should not worship the devils and the idols of gold and silver and brass and stone and of wood, which neither can see nor hear nor walk. Neither repented they of their murders, and nor of their sorceries, nor of their fornication, of their thefts. Those miracles, the purpose of the devil is to hinder you from repentance and redemption. What are we repenting of? We need money, we've got the money. I need a wife, I've got the wife. We need children, we've got children. We need a job, we've got a job. We want our enemies to die, our enemies have died. And we want the people that are trading with us, when we cheat them for something to blindfold them so they will not see. And everything is happening. We're having our way. We're having our profit. Everything is going our way. What have I got repentance? What have I got to do with repentance? All those miracles, the purpose of the miracles is to hinder repentance and redemption. Then number four, it is to heighten and increase your suffering. It is to heighten and increase suffering. The people that are deceived by those miracles of the false prophets, it will increase their suffering. In Jeremiah chapter 28, Jeremiah chapter 28, I'm reading from verse 12. Then the word of the Lord came unto Jeremiah the prophet. After that, Ananiah the prophet had broken the yoke from up the neck of the prophet Jeremiah, saying, go and tell Ananiah, saying, thus says the Lord, thou hast broken the yokes of wood, but thou hast made for them yokes of iron. You see, the yokes of wood will be broken. That is, the people that, you know, fell, that, you know, this Christian life, self-denial, sacrifice, separation from the world. How can I endure that? It's like, you know, the yoke of the Lord that is easy. The yoke of wood is taken away, and these false lying wonders will create a yoke of iron for you. For thus says the Lord in verse 14, the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, I have put a yoke of iron upon the neck of all these nations, that they will serve Nebuchadnezzar the king of Babylon, and they shall serve him, and I have given him the beasts of the field also. Then said the prophet Jeremiah unto Ananiah the prophet, hear now, Ananiah, the Lord has not sent thee, but thou makest these people to trust in a lie. Thou makest these people to trust in a lie. And that is the things that the people do, those false miracles will make you to trust in a lie, and actually will bring heightened suffering. Number five, it is to make you honor the seducer and reject the Savior. You will honor the seducer, you will honor the false prophet, you will honor the people that are leading you astray, and then you will reject the Savior. In Mark chapter 13, verse 22, Mark chapter 13, verse 22, for false Christ and false prophet shall arise, and shall show signs and wonders to seduce, if it were possible, even the very elect. But take heed, behold, I foretold you all things. All those miracles of the false prophets will make the people that believe those miracles to honor the seducer and to reject the Savior. Number six, it is to hook souls for hell. That is, once you get there and they get you interested, they hold you down, and it's like a hook. You are just there, and they pin you down there, and they keep you down there for hellfire. That's exactly what will happen on the last days. When the false prophet, when he begins to work all those miracles, it will hook those people down, hold them down until they receive the mark of the beast, and eventually they get into hellfire. Revelation chapter 13, reading from verse 13. And he doeth great wonders, so that he maketh fire to come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men. And he deceiveth them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles which he had power to do in the sight of the beast, saying to them that dwell on the earth that they should make an image to the beast which had the wound by a sword and did live. For and he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the beast, the image of the beast shall be killed. And then in chapter 14, verse 9, chapter 14, reading from verse 9, here it tells us, and the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image, and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation. And he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. And the smoke of their torment ascendeth up forever and ever. And they have no rest in all night to worship the beast and his image, and whosoever receiveth the mark of his name. Well, the Lord has warned us so that we will not be attracted and will not be taken away of.